बड़ा बढ़िया सा बनना है, परफेक्ट. इफ आई रिड्यूस द साइज इट इवन बिकम्स परफेक्ट, इवन मोर. You can just take a snaps of what I am writing. You don't need to write down. Anyways, okay, please focus here. This is velocity here. Velocity, velocity, velocity. Direction of acceleration, can you show quickly? Direction of acceleration. Quickly, show it. Direction of acceleration. Focus here. So direction of acceleration is where? Inwards, like this. What is the magnitude? V square by R, everywhere. Okay? So we have shown the velocity and acceleration at four points. So all other points also I can show. Now tell me, is the magnitude of velocity changing? No. Magnitude of acceleration changing? No. Right? So these two things are fixed. But the equation, you remember equations of motion? V is equal to u plus at, s equal to ut plus half at square. All these equations track the magnitudes. Okay? Okay? So all these equations usually track the magnitudes. Right? But here what we should track?
Direction.
I just need to track where the particle is and I can find out its velocity and acceleration. Because the magnitude of velocity and acceleration is fixed. Right? So essentially I need to track at what, how much angle it has rotated. Right? I don't have to track how much is the displacement. When the object is going in a straight line, I need to track the displacement, change in displacement, and then change in velocity. But if object is going in a circle, I just need to track the direction. Okay. Now, what is the best variable to track the direction? What is the best variable to track the direction? Angle. Angle is a variable. If I tell you what is the best variable to track the displacement, it will be length only, right? Amount of path. If I am asking you, how should I track the direction, angle is made for that. Okay, so instead of displacement, I will track what? I will track the amount of angle the object has rotated. Getting it? And by the way, when we analyze a circular motion, we are dealing in SI units. So angles, SI unit is? Radius. Okay. So, we need to introduce angular variables to track the angles. What is the angular variable? The first angular variable is amount of angle it has raised, okay, which is delta theta, let's say. Delta theta is similar to the displacement. Change in position vector is displacement, right? Similarly, change in angle is angular displacement. Change in angle. If initial angle is 30 degree, final angle is 45 degree, delta theta is how much? 15. Okay? Now, rate of change of angle d theta by dt is similar to dr by dt. Now, can you tell me what is dr by dt? Here by dt is velocity. Yes or no? Dr by dt is velocity, and this is called angular velocity, rate at which angle changes. Okay, this is represented by symbol omega. Okay, fine. R is a position. Any doubts till now? Now, can you tell me if delta theta is the angle, if delta theta is the angle, angular displacement, can you tell me how much distance the particle has moved? R delta theta. This is how we define the angles, right? Arc length divided by radius. Arc length divided by radius is the angle or not? Right? So the arc length is radius into angle in radians. Okay? So this is the distance. If delta theta is the angle of rotation, please write down. If delta theta is the angle of rotation, R delta theta is the distance. R delta theta is the distance. Okay? Fine? Now, d theta by dt is what? Is omega. Dr by dt is v. Dr is what? Dr is a very small displacement. That I can write it as r d theta or not? Dr is a small displacement. That I can write as r d theta. See, it is moving in a circle. So if it is going in a very small angle, let's say delta theta, this length is r d theta. This length is r d theta. This is d theta. Okay? So dr is r d theta. So this is r d theta by dt, which is what? R into omega. Okay? Please write down velocity at any moment. Velocity at any moment will be equal to r times omega. Will be equal to r times omega. R omega. V is equal to r omega. If you know the angular velocity, you can find the speed of the particle. Right? So dr is r d theta divided by dt. So d theta by dt is what? Omega. Okay? Clear? So till now we have introduced omega, which is d theta by dt, and we have also introduced v is equal to omega times r. Okay? There is a term called angular acceleration. Okay? Angular acceleration is d omega by dt. Just like you remember, acceleration is dv by dt. Similarly, there is a term angular acceleration which is d omega by dt. Okay? Are you getting it? So, if A is constant, then V is equal to U plus AT, S equal to UT plus half AT square, and V square equal to U square plus 2AS. Right? If A is constant. Now, this is what mathematical solution of this equation. Now, if there is a very similar equation like this, Instead of V, I am writing omega. Instead of A, I am writing alpha. So the solution look exactly same or not? Right? The solution of this equation, if alpha is constant, should be what? Tell me. What will be the solution of this equation? Instead of V, what should be there? Omega. So omega is equal to initial angle of velocity plus alpha into t. Very similar looking expression. Okay? And what? Angular displacement is your linear displacement. Delta theta will be equal to omega naught t plus half alpha t square. And third one will be what?
Omega square
equals to omega naught square plus 2 alpha delta. R is very similar looking.
So alpha is momentum.
Alpha is angular acceleration. A is linear acceleration.
So omega is delta.
What is what?
Omega
naught is initial angular velocity. Any doubts? Any other doubt? We can take up numericals now. Any doubts? Achha, by the way, tell me one thing. There, when A is deceleration, I take A as negative, and if I am taking velocity positive, is there something called angular deceleration also? Is there a direction? Basically, I am asking, is there a direction sense of omega and alpha? There is. Clockwise and anti-clockwise. Okay, something wrong, let's say that an object is going like this. This is the initial angular velocity. Okay? And angular acceleration is in this direction. This is alpha. Then what? If you're taking omega is positive, alpha is negative. Because it is decreasing the angular velocity now. Getting it? Direction sense can be checked by clockwise and anti-clockwise. That's all. Any doubts? Okay, let's take up few numericals. Okay, an object is revolving in a circle with 60 RPM. RPM is what? Revolutions per minute. Okay? We need to find out. Amount of angle object rotates in 10 seconds. Constant angular velocity. Okay, what answer you are getting? 20 pi. All of you getting 20 pi? Which equation you are using? Let's see randomly. Which? No, I understand. Listen here, listen. The thing is that you don't even know which equation you have used. Are you getting it? You have got the answer from the intuition, or probably the way you have just look at the data and you multiply it with 10 and all that. That is fine, absolutely fine. But if you have not followed the step, you will not be able to replicate the same way of problem solving for the complicated question. Okay? So you must know which equation you have used. You have only three equations to use. What are they? Omega is equal to omega naught plus alpha into t and all that. Tell me which equation will you use? Theta theta is equal to omega naught t plus. I am asking. What is alpha equals to? What is alpha equal to here? Alpha is 0. Please write down in a uniform circular motion, in a uniform circular motion, angular acceleration is 0. In a uniform circular motion, angular acceleration is 0. So remember, if an object travels in a with a constant velocity, displacement is not velocity into time. Similarly, here also, if constant angular velocity, the angle is, if this is 0, will be simply omega into t. Omega is how much? In SI units. What is omega here? None of you are telling. 2 pi. 2 pi radians per second. This is one revolution per second or not? In one revolution, how many radians are there? 2 pi. So if you have to write in SI units, the answer is 2 pi radians per second. So omega is 2 pi radians per second. So delta theta is 2 pi into 10, which is? Getting it? Yes, sir. Any doubts? No doubts?